It was Jelle Dirks of the festival Lunalia here in Mechelen who invited me and invited my ensemble Grand Lava to focus a new program on this composer, Philippe de Monte, a little bit forgotten composer, and I found it quite appropriate to call the program also Forgetting Philippe de Monte. So it is at the same time forgetting Philippe de Monte as it is Philippe de Monte forgotten. Alfred Einstein, the big scholar of the Italian Renaissance madrigal, he said about de Monte, he called him the Don Quixote of the Italian madrigal. Why? Because de Monte came always too early or too late with his production, and he was all the time trapped into his own failures. And I think on one hand it's true, but on the other hand, I would think that exactly this Quixotism of de Monte makes him into maybe one of the first real modern composers. Not modern in the sense of the music of his own time, let's say the early Baroque music and so on, but modern in a much more contemporary, actual way, a modernity who jumps out of its own contemporary culture. Always complaining that his works got not the success that he had hoped, that he, in fact everything was a little bit in vain, that all he made, you can read the forewords of his madrigal books, mostly he says, yeah, my previous madrigal book was a failure, I try again, but I know already that nobody will like it, and so on and so forth. So de Monte was a little bit a composer who constantly, you can say, articulated his obstacle, the obstacle of his own failures, his own miseries, and so on. My idea was, is it not possible that we could draw a kind of artistic line in the compositions of de Monte, in this vast oeuvre of 1,200 compositions, to find a line there where we see that kind of artist at work, the artist who is not submitting to his own time, who is stubbornly sticking to his own artistic drive, and repeats this continuously without in fact ending. And every failure is in this line exactly something, not just an obstacle, it's also the trigger to continue with what he's trying to achieve. So in fact, the compositional line that I made is a kind of hidden line of dark compositions, of really dark and dense compositions, all turning around failure, miseries, and the obstacles of Philippe de Monte's life. You can say his real life, biographic life, or his imaginary life, the idea as an artist, how you fantasize your own obstacles, your own miseries, and so on.